Is it possible to dynamically highlight the max and min values of a line chart in Excel? So something like this, where we conditionally format max and min in our line graph. And of course, we want it to be dynamic, so once our numbers change, the max and min formatting adjusts as well. What do you think? What you just saw was in Excel, so yes, it's possible, and it's really not that difficult either. So here I have some sales data per month. Based on this, I'm going to insert a line chart. So just highlight the range, go to Insert, Line, and I'm going to add a line chart with markers. If I was going to highlight the max point manually, I would click on this line series once, click on the max point again, and then change the color of that marker under format, right? But I don't want to do it like this because the downside of this is that it's not dynamic. If in September I happen to have lower sales, let's say I just make 100 in sales, this color is not going to transfer to the month that has the highest sales. It's going to stay there. I don't want that. I want to conditionally format this series so that my max month, so the month I had the highest sales, is going to automatically get a green marker, and the month I had the worst sales is going to get a red marker. So I'm just going to press Ctrl Z to go back. Now here's the thing. Anytime you want to conditionally format anything in a chart, you need to add a new series. And in this case, I want to conditionally format two things, right? The max and the min in different colors, which means I need two different series. Now, what numbers do I put in these series? All I want in there is the month that has the maximum value. And for this series, the month that has the minimum value. Everything else should be empty. So here I can use an if logical test and check, is this number here equal to the max of my number range here? I'm planning to pull this down, so I'm going to fix the reference with the F4 key. Now, if it is, I want to see that number. Otherwise, well, first let's go with nothing. I don't want to see anything. So I'm just going to push this down and I get one number. So that's the number that's the maximum in this range here. For my min series, it's pretty much identical. So I'm just going to copy this, press escape to leave, come here and paste and change the max to min and send this down. Okay, so now I have my two additional series. I want to bring them inside the chart. So I'm just going to click on the chart. So on the border of the chart, don't click on the plot area here, but on the border here, and then expand this to add the series here. Now, something very strange happens because even though I just have these two numbers and I only want to plot these two numbers, I see a lot of lines on the x-axis. And that's because nothing in the formula means zero to Excel. And it means zero for the line chart. So it's actually plotting 0, 0, 0 until it gets to this number and the rest is zeros again. Here's the trick. When you work with line charts and you want to cut your line, you don't want it to crash to zero. Instead of nothing, you can use the NA error. I'm going to do the same for the min, and we're going to see the effect in a second when I pull this down. So check this out. Everything disappeared except for these 2 points. Now I'm free to format these the way I like. So let's click on this series and notice that I'm not clicking two times, right? Because two times means that I'm only selecting this one point, which is something I don't want to do. I want to select the entire max series here because I want to format the entire series in a different color. So to format this, I'm going to use the shortcut key Ctrl+1 to bring up the format data series. I'm just going to bring this closer here. Now, another way, instead of clicking on a series and formatting it, you can also select the series name from the dropdown here. So if you're not sure whether you've clicked on the right series, you can select it from here. So now I know I'm in the entire series max, and under color, I want to adjust the marker here. Under marker options, I'm going to go with built-in. I'm fine with the circle here. I just want to increase this to 10. And I want to take away the fill color, so no fill, and add a solid border to this that's green. And I'm also going to increase the border to this. Now let's format the min series as well. So let's go and select min from here. Built-in size should be 10, no fill. And for border, let's go with a red color and make this the same size as for the max series. Okay, so let's also format this series in the background. I'm going to change the fill color of the marker to a darker gray, and I'm going to change the line color to a dark gray as well. Now these markers also generally have borders on them, so I'm going to take away the border from the markers on this line. Okay, so this looks much better. For the grid lines, let's just make them a lot lighter than they are. To make this easier to read, let's add the data label for the max series. So now again, I'm going to add the data label for the entire max series. Let's just right mouse click, add data labels, and push the data labels to the top. Let's click above, right? Because the max series is always going to be on top. It fits better to have the label above it. For the min series, we are just going to send it to the bottom. So add data labels, let's push them to the bottom. And of course, you can color this in red and color this in green if you want. They're both two separate series. Now let's just add a title to this and let's test. Okay, so let's say in May, we had a great month. We sold 300. That switches there. In November, we had a bad month and we just sold 100. Okay, so this is fully dynamic. It works perfectly well. Now there is one thing that might bother you, and that's having errors in your Excel file. We generally try to always avoid having errors in our spreadsheet. So one thing you can do is to hide the series from view. Normally I group them instead of hiding the column. So I would go to data and group from here and group them like this. But here's the catch: when you do that and Excel doesn't see the series here, it actually doesn't show it on your chart. To avoid this, there is a setting. So just right mouse click anywhere in the chart, go to select data, and down here where it says hidden and empty cells, click on show data in hidden rows and columns, and we can see it come back here. Okay, so that's one way you can hide the NA. Another way is to use conditional formatting and just change the font color. So that's how you can conditionally format a line chart to highlight the max and min values. Now here's the great thing. You can use this technique for anything you want to highlight in a dynamic way. So for example, the months you held marketing campaigns, or highlight the top 3 months. You just have to come up with a formula to use instead of the min and max formulas. That was it for today. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you want to improve your Excel knowledge, consider subscribing to this channel.